And this is part of the exercise on positive logic programs with variables. We have these two facts. The first says that next to 0 is 1, and the second that next to 1 is 2. And we have these two rules now with variables that says that for every x and y, if next to x is y, then x is before. And we have that if next to x is y, and y is before, then y is also between. Yes, this is right. I thought I had written it incorrectly, but that's exactly what it's about. Good, let's do this quickly. We have the Hebrand universe. We just have 0, 1, and 2. We have the predicates next with two arguments, before with one argument, and between with one argument, and now we have to build the Hebrand base using the predicates and all possible arguments that we can use from the Hebrand universe. Then let's start here. So as in the previous exercise, we will have quite many instances of this predicate, exactly 9. So let's do this. We have next 0, 0, next 0, 1, and next 0, 2, and then the same, but starting with the 1, next 1, 0, next 1, 1, next 1, 2, and then with the 2. I'm sorry if the pen annoys you a bit, but I haven't managed to get rid of this noise. Maybe in the post-processing I managed to do something, but so far I haven't done it. Okay, let's go with before. 0, before 1, then before 2. And then with between, the same story. Between of 0, between of 1, and between of 2. And this is the Hebrand base of this program P. Now for the ground instantiation of P, we have this rule. Let's write these two. The facts, we just copy them. Okay, and this will be quite some, because we have x and y, and so x and y here, x and y there. So this will boil down to 9 instances of this rule, because we have 9 possible combinations of two elements of this set, and we have 9 also here. So this will get really big, 18. So I am going to write it, and maybe you just want to scroll to the moment when I'm done with this. So I write here the possibilities 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 2, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 2, and 2, 0, 2, 1, 2, 2. And there we go. So now let's go when x has the value 1. I think I go faster if I just do it like this. And then with next 2 something. And here before 2, before 2, and before 2. And then comes this rule. So these are all the ground rules of the third rule of the program. And now I'm going to do the ground instantiations of the fourth rule. So I have between 0 if next, 0, 0 before 0. And to not get lost, I'm going to write all this next beforehand. Ba-ba-da-ba. Yeah, as you see, this is really easy. One just has to pay attention not to make mistakes and always check in the end. Okay, so these are the XYs, and here I have to put before Y and between Y. So I just care about this number, which is the Y. Before 1, before 2, before 0. And then here we have the between. Oops, this is a zero. Yeah, you know, this is not the most interesting exercise to do, but I think it's at least good to do it once in your lifetime so that you get the feeling of how big things can get when grounding. No, and these are still a small example, but maybe a bit of this intuition that it may get big stays in your head after the exercise. That would be a nice consequence of this. Nice, then let's check. So I have that I did all the substitution here correctly. 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 2, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 2, 2, 0, 2, 1, 2, 2. And then the Y appears in the others. 1, 1, 1, 2, 2, 2, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 2, 2, 2, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 2, 2, 2. And this way you check and you are sure that this is correct. And we close it. So this big thing is the ground instantiation of the program. Now to compute the stable model, we just have this fact. Next 0, oops, let's change the color. Next 0, 1, and next 1, 2. And let's see, where do these atoms appear to be able to derive more things? So here I have next 0, 1, so I can derive before 0. And does this next 0, 1 appear somewhere else? Maybe here. And for this to fire, I need before 1. And with next 1, 2, it appears here, so I can derive before 1. And here, this next 1, 2 appears here. And if I have before 2, I can derive between 2. But actually what happens is that I have before 1 from this rule, so I can get between 1. But between does not occur in anybody, and this next would need before 2, but there's no way to derive this before, because for this we would need some next of 2, and we don't have any next of 2 something. So then we cannot apply any more rules. Let's do this quickly again, because the next only occur here. This, so the only rule that could also fire is this with before of the and before 2, but we don't have before 2. And then Yeah, and then the rules with before 0 and before 1 require the next. So given that we have checked already the next, then we don't have to check anything else. And with this between 1, we cannot fire any more rules. So that's it. Then this table model has this next, the facts, of course, plus these 1, 2, 3 other atoms that we have derived before 0, before 1, and between 1. Good. So then this solves the exercise, and now let's do it as we did it before, just working on the non-ground logic program, which it may be easier, but what is, of course, is faster. So we will get these two facts, next 0, 1 and next 1, 2. Now with this next, we cannot derive anything from this rule because we need before, but from here we can get the two before 0 and before 1. So we will derive before 0 and before 1. Then from this rule, we cannot get anything else because we have used the next that we have in a way, and we will not get anything else. So then we just have to see what consequences can we obtain from this rule. So if we have before of y and next of xy, we can get the between. So we have next 0, 1, and we have before 1, so then we can get the between 1. And that's it, because with the before 0, we would need a next of something and 0, and there's no such thing. So then we know we can stop, and then the stable model contains these two atoms and these three. Of course, when you do the exercise for real in an exam, or you are just working with the logic programs, you don't have to do all. If you just want to compute the stable model, you don't have to write the ground instantiation of the program. You may just do it like we did it here at the end, right? This is why I do it twice, to show you different methods, and then you can check, you can choose the one that fits better for you. Good, so that was it. I hope you understood it well and you enjoyed it. So, ciao.